Let's learn about the bicarbonate buffer system. Blood is maintained at a narrow range of pH, which is between 7.35 and 7.45. Serious problems result from blood that is too acidic or alkaline. Abnormal pH can lead to coma and death. One of the ways by which the body maintains the blood pH is through buffers. The most important buffer in the blood is the bicarbonate ion buffer. Before we see how it works, let's review a little bit about acids and bases. Acids are molecules that tend to give up hydrogen ions. For example, hydrochloric acid dissociates into hydrogen ions and chloride ions. As a solution's hydrogen ion concentration increases, its pH goes down, making the solution more acidic. Bases tend to combine with hydrogen ions, neutralizing them to form water. For example, sodium hydroxide dissociates into sodium and hydroxyl groups. The hydroxyl ion combines with the hydrogen ion, neutralizing it. As a solution's hydrogen ion concentration decreases, its pH goes up, making the solution more alkaline. If there are too many hydrogen ions or an increase in hydrogen ion concentration in the blood, the bicarbonate ion combines with the hydrogen ion to form carbonic acid. If there are too few hydrogen ions or a decrease in hydrogen ion concentration, carbonic acid dissociates into hydrogen ions and bicarbonate ions, thereby increasing the hydrogen ion concentration. We can use this equation to illustrate how an increase in hydrogen ion concentration, or acidosis, causes the reaction to move toward the left, which promotes the formation of carbonic acid. Likewise, a decrease in hydrogen ion concentration, or alkalosis, causes the reaction to move to the right, promoting the dissociation of carbonic acid into hydrogen and bicarbonate ions. In addition to buffer systems, the respiratory system also works to maintain pH. For example, if blood becomes too acidic, respiration rate increases in order to rid the body of carbon dioxide. A subsequent decrease in hydrogen ions occurs. Likewise, if blood becomes too alkaline, respiration rate decreases in order to increase the hydrogen ion concentration. You could say that hydrogen ion concentration follows carbon dioxide concentration. I hope you've learned something about the bicarbonate ion buffer, and see you next time.